with you.
And with your spirit.
On this solemn Sunday, we pray with the family of the late Marie Gallo. She was an alumni and a great supporter of NDNU. And Marie belonged to the class of 1957. And her great love and support for Notre Dame, especially among those who know her, can never be quantified in mathematical terms. So having been called to eternal rest, we pray with and offer this mass for the family and then also for the peaceful repose of Marie Gallo. On a special note, we also pray with and for our friend Magdalene June, who celebrates the birthday today. In accordance with the love that each and every one of us have for all mothers, we remember to pray for them since today is a Mother's Day. And congratulations to all mothers. With all this in mind, let us ask God for pardon, mercy, and forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came down to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right-hand side of the Father, interceding for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and grant us life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we, in honor of the risen Christ, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him and, falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up. I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also. For they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people, who have received the Holy Spirit even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. The Lord has revealed to the nation his saving power. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him. His holy arm. The Lord has revealed to the nation his saving power. The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love. Not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Whoever loves me will keep my word, says the Lord, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Written from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, as the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy will be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you to. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends in Christ, once again, I feel very privileged to invite our brother, Sir Ross, to give us the spiritual reflection.
I would like to thank Father Samuel for allowing me to provide this spiritual reflection. What wonderful readings to hear on Mother's Day. We are told by Jesus, as I have loved you, love one another. Wow, is that not the essence of what every mother wants for their child? These readings and motherhood go hand in hand, for being a mother is an act of unending, limitless love. It matters not if you birth, chose, or in some other way became responsible for a child. Love is what defines and motivates your actions from this moment forward. A mother, grandmother, and if some are really lucky, a great-grandmother, is an unstoppable force when it comes to loving and protecting their child. In fact, a mother's love is so great that the prophet Isaiah compares it to God's love for each of us. Isaiah speaks of God telling us, "Can a mother forget her infant, but without tenderness for the child of her womb? Even should she forget, I will never forget you." And a few chapters later, "As a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort you. In Jerusalem, you shall find comfort." Most of us learned how to love from our mother. The nurturing, healing, protecting, and sacrifices she made starting when we were young for her whole life. In fact, for all birth mothers, this starts at the moment of conception. Only rarely will a mother forget her child, even if the child was given up for adoption. I know of more than one such mother that prayed for years for the protection of that child, and then rejoiced when reunited with that child that they had not seen since birth. A mother's love endures and is limited only by the at times superhuman capabilities of their physical body. But my brothers and sisters in Christ, the readings today remind us, just as Isaiah did, that God's love is unfathomably greater. In the first reading, we hear that God loves everyone, that God is truly impartial, for we are all God's children. Remember, God will never abandon you. All that God's asked for us to do is return his love. Even though God speaks of his love for all in Genesis, Peter was compelled to remind the Jews of that time to recognize, accept, and embrace the grace of the Holy Spirit that was filling and converting the Gentiles into the first Christians. If you have any doubt of this, John reminds us in the second reading that we must love one another because everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. So to know God, you must love others because all are created in God's image, and God loves all he has created. This is the foundation of our faith, why God sent his son to be birthed by the Blessed Virgin Mary so Jesus could be the expiator of all our sins, past, present, and future. This is reinforced by Jesus in the gospel when he teaches, as the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. Jesus calls on us to remain in his love by keeping his commandment because he keeps all of his Father's commandments. Jesus makes it easy for us. He only needs 7 words. Love one another as I love you. 7 words to remind us of God the Father taking 7 days to create all that is good and establish a day of rest. Yes, to remind us of perfection that can only come from God. Wow, such a concise yet limitless perfect commandments to encompass all other commandments. As we grow in faith, we will come to understand this commandment is a lifelong task that we will continually have to work on to achieve. Please remember that when Jesus spoke of this before, he was questioned regarding which commandment is the greatest. And Jesus answered, love of God and love of others. Because if you do this in an imitation of God's love, then all other commandments are fulfilled. This is why we must love and respect all others, especially those that we do not agree with. God created all, every single person in every nation, in every corner of the earth, in his image. He gave everyone free will. And if God continues to allow people to choose freely, we must respect their choice to exercise their free will. This takes us back to the beginning of this reflection, the unceasing love of a mother. I think it is safe for me to state that a mother does not always love what their child does, but they always love their child. So to Jesus, and so to God the Father, for each and every one of us. So on this day of celebrating all mothers, let us also remember our spiritual mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary. Think of what she endured and how that experience led to her become the mother of our church, and thus a mother to us all. Her love of us is so great that her chosen quest is to lead us to her Son, so her Son can lead us to God the Father. Can she love us any more than that? So today, let us thank and pray for all our mothers, be they physical or spiritual, and include every grandmother, great-grandmother, and godmother. May they all love us as God loves. Inspire us to love as God loves, and may they be an example to always say yes to love as God loves. With this in mind, and remembering that we celebrate the Blessed Virgin Mary this whole month of May, by praying the rosary to ask for her intercessory help with her son, let us all join together with the Blessed Virgin Mary as a united community of Christ, focused on sharing God's love, and pray that the spread of COVID, especially in those areas like India and Brazil, become curtailed, and that we may all be healed physically, emotionally, and spiritually of its effects by praying. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
Pray, dear friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of which your mighty love endures, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Salvatore, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Mary Gallo. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray, especially for your daughter, Magdalene June, who celebrate the birthday today, and the family of Mary Gallus, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her most spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to sing.
Our Father, who
distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord remain always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, Jesus, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The